much. I appreciate that. Thank y'all. How's everybody? Appreciate you. Thank you very much. Well, welcome to Family Feud, Ghana. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. I'm excited to be here, so let's get it on. Etisan, Ghana. Researchers have been out on the streets of Ghana asking you some answers to some really simple questions. So now these families have to guess what those answers are that we have locked on the game board behind me. The family that answers the most questions get the most points. At the end of the game, it's gonna be playing for the jackpot. $5,000, man. So if you wanna meet the families, everybody say yeah.
Yeah!
All right, this is from Pima. It's the LI-JUAN family. They're playing against from Greater Accra. It's the BORKETEY family.
Victory!
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 Victory! Well, we might as well get it on. You ready for the show? Everybody say yeah.
Yeah!
Let's go, give me Bruce, give me Michael. All right, Bruce, all right. Yeah. 30-minute show, need you to come on, get up here. We just got 30 minutes. Name a subject Steve was good at in school.
English.
What?
English.
We on, baby.
Pass or play?
We're playing.
We got 3 minutes, man.
We are playing, yes. Let's go. Listen to me. There were not 7 subjects I was good at school ever. This whole question is a lie. Only one. Only one. We'll see if so. Hey, man, how you doing?
Doing great.
All right. What do you do for a living?
I'm a chemist by profession.
A chemist?
Yeah.
Oh. All right, Bruce, introduce everybody.
This is my friend Joseph, banker by profession. That's Seraphim, my wife, banker by profession. And Joseph, my brother, fashion designer by profession. Oh.
So, Joseph, you are a banker?
Yes, sir.
Oh, good. How long you been doing that?
7 years.
7 years?
Yes, please.
Yes. Are you married?
No, sir.
No, sir. But maybe one day.
Very soon.
Very soon. You have your eye on her?
Yeah.
Well, you got your eye on her. Does she have her eye on you?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
Yeah, see, we got to talk with her. Yeah, see, you can want her, but if she don't want you, we got problems.
Yeah.
We got to find out. Let me stop talking to you. Let me talk to a woman. Serafini?
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Very beautiful.
Thank you.
Do you know this woman?
Yeah.
Yeah. She is a nice woman.
Very nice.
Very nice.
Very nice.
He should ask her.
I think so.
How long have they been together?
3 years.
3?
Yeah.
Oh my God. 3 years. How old are you?
37.
37? What is he waiting for? 3 years at 37. It's time to come on in. You have been out there by yourself long enough.
Steve, I'm coming very soon, this year.
Okay.
I'm coming.
You have decided.
Yes, I have.
You are coming.
I'm coming.
She is the one.
I'm coming.
Name a subject Steve was good at in school.
Steve, I think I'll go for mathematics.
What?
Mathematics.
That's a good answer.
Steve, that's a good answer. I think it's on the board.
It's 7 answers on the board.
Yes.
I can tell you right now, I was only good at one thing in school. Only one thing. It was not math. Mathematics. Serafini.
Hello.
What do you do?
I'm a banker.
And you're married to?
Yeah.
The first
Bruce.
Boy.
How did you meet him?
We met at school.
Oh, back in school?
Yeah.
Oh, so you saw him early and went?
He saw me and.
Whoa, you better go, girl. You better go, girl. Girl, you better say it. No, 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 Uncle Steve. He saw me.
Yeah.
You saw she's so fine, you said, oh, man.
Wow.
There's no way you could do better than this.
Wow, I tell you.
I know. Look.
Very pretty.
Look, and look at you. How? How? What did you say to make her go, yes?
I told you I love her.
Did you know when you first met her that she was the one?
Yeah.
Soon as you met her?
I think I was emceeing a program then. Mm-hmm. So I saw her in the crowd. I was like,
oh,
wow.
She was in the crowd?
Yeah.
Oh, like, a lot of people?
Yeah.
You picked her out?
Yeah, so I was like, wow, this is going to be my wife. So I managed somewhere.
Oh, whoa, whoa. You just said, oh, wow, look right there. She is going to be my wife.
Yeah.
Just like that?
Just like that.
And
I said it to myself.
She is there.
Yeah.
She is your wife.
Yeah.
The same thing. I saw Marjorie. First time I saw Marjorie. You know what I told her? I was in a comedy club. This was back in 86. She walked in, I was performing. She came down front with a girlfriend, she was late. When I saw her, I could not breathe.
Yeah.
I stopped talking. This was a beautiful girl. I looked at her and said, I don't know who you are. This was the first thing I ever said to her. I don't know who you are in front of everybody, but I'm gonna marry you one day.
Right.
I told her that. She sat in her seat, she said, you don't even know me. We are married.
That's great.
Beautiful, that's how it works. A man knows almost right away. We almost know right away. So, Serafini, name a subject Steve was good at in school.
Steve, you look smart, so I'll go in for science.
I don't know who these 100 people are, but I gotta tell you something. They have no idea who I really am. I didn't know nothing. Science. I'm gonna tell you something. Do you know, I only got one A the entire time I was in school. It was the same subject every year. I'm only good at one thing. I got so many D's, so many F's. I got a C one time. My father bought me a bike. Science! Augustine.
Sir?
Sir? Sir? What do you do for a living?
Well, I'm a fashion designer and an entrepreneur.
You make men's fashions? What do you make?
I make men's fashion.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Do you know chocolate?
Yeah, I know chocolate.
You know chocolate?
One of the best designs we have in Ghana.
Yes. Chocolate, all of the traditional wear that I wear on Family Feud, chocolate made for me.
Wow. Yeah. He's a genius, you know? He's a genius.
Very good.
He's good at what he does.
So, this is how I met him. He came with a bag. He came to my best friend's office. He said, Mr. Steve, I have a present for you. I made you an outfit, a caftan. I said, you didn't even take my measurements. How can you make me clothes without measurements? He said, I've been studying you for years.
Wow.
I know you are 6'2". I said, really? I took this outfit, put it on, perfect fit. He never took my measurements.
Wow, wow, that's good.
All right, let's go, man. Name a subject Steve was good at in school.
Steve. In fact, looking at you, I think you love music.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, wasn't a subject, though.
Yeah.
Music!
Good answer, good answer.
If that had been a subject in school, I would have got an A. All right, only one strike. Bruce, name a subject Steve was good at in school.
Steve, I'll go for arts. Visual arts.
Visual arts.
Yeah.
That's like?
Drawing.
Drawing.
Yeah.
My nephew could draw, I can't draw. Drawing, visual arts.
Good answer, good answer.
All right, we got two strikes, Joseph. We have to be careful. Borketeey family can steal. Name a subject Steve was good at in school.
Steve, I think you love geography.
Geography?
Yes.
That's a good answer.
That's a good answer.
It's on the board.
Geography.
Hey, dog, listen to me. I'm 63 years old. I still cannot spell geography. G-E-O. G-R-A-P-H-Y.
You are the man.
I have no idea how I did that. I just pulled it right out. Geography.
That's a good answer.
Name a subject Steve was good at in school.
Steve, you're gonna love history.
I hate history. History.
That's a good answer, boy.
I hated history. I'm African American. What am I studying history for? For 400 years we were slaves. What I give a damn about history? I hated history. I hated school. I was only good at one thing. Number six.
Psychology.
Five.
Drama.
We didn't have that at our school. Number four. Feud, everybody. L'Jouan family not on the board. Borketeey family got 48. Give me Joseph. Give me Evan. Yeah. You athlete, man?
No, please.
You don't play nothing?
No.
You're not fast? Run track?
No.
400 meters?
No, please.
I could get you nice, man. You know box?
No, please.
Oh. Man, I could get you nice.
Mm-hmm. A little soccer, bit. Play soccer.
Oh, soccer.
Football, yeah. Soccer.
Oh, that's good. Soccer. Yeah, I can't help you with that. I can't. I kick a ball, I fall. Beautiful. Anyway, let's go. We surveyed 100 people. We got top 7 answers on the board. Name something people balance on their head.
A ball.
A fruit tree.
Fruit.
Good answer.
Yeah, yeah. We are playing. Want to play?
Okay, we're gonna play.
Come on, guys.
Something people about. I've been watching that since I've been here. It's an amazing thing that a lot of people can do, especially the women. Carry everything on their head. I'll break my neck. Snap. Can't do it. Serafini, name something people balance on their head.
Water. A bowl of water.
Augustine.
Sir?
Sir?
I love his voice. I don't know where it comes from.
Sir?
But you can't surprise him because he's gonna surprise you back. Augustine.
Yeah!
Name something people balance on their head.
Steve, I'll go for clothes.
Clothes. Yeah. Clothes.
good answer. That's a good answer.
Bruce, one strike. Name something people balance on their head.
Cement.
Gray stuff, get wet, make a building.
Yeah,
put that
yeah.
on their head.
Yeah.
You seen that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. In Africa, they carry. In Ghana.
When somebody was building the house and put the cement on their head and took it over there. In Ghana, you carry the cement.
Yeah.
Is it in a bag?
Yeah, in a bag.
That's 30 kilograms, 35 kilograms.
25 kilos, 25 kilos.
25, yeah, for a bag of cement.
Yeah.
They put the cement on their head.
Exactly.
And they walk with it.
Yeah.
You've seen them.
Exactly.
This is crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Your donuts is crazy. So your neck. Put the cement on the head, you're building the building, and walk it over there and put it on the building.
That's a good answer.
Wasn't a bad answer, though. I've seen everything in Ghana. Ghana is more than everywhere else. Ghana, man, whew. Your turn. Two strikes. Be careful. Bogetey family can steal. Name something people balance on their head.
Steve, I think people balance cap. Cap, as in hat.
A hat.
Yeah. Yes.
Oh. A cap.
A cap.
C-A-P.
Yes, a cap.
C-U-P.
No, it's not C-U-P.
C-A-P,
okay. C-U-P is a cup.
A cup, okay.
I thought he said cape, you know, Batman, Superman, cape.
No,
but
no.
He was saying cap.
Cap.
Yeah. Cap.
Cap.
Excellent answer. That's not going to be up there. Balance the cap on your head. Name something people balance on their head.
In Ghana, we're balancing a lot of bread.
A lot of bread. I'm telling you, I saw it. I see it's there. Bread is there. It's there. It is not there.
Give it, give it.
It is not there. Number seven.
Books.
Six.
Basket.
Five.
Balls and punts.
Three.
Bags.
One.
Buckets.
Well, that was round two, everybody. LI-JUAN family got 29. BORKETEY family got 48. We got a game now, folks. It done got tight. Don't go away, but after the break, we're going to play for double the points. It's close now. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Now we got a game, folks. LI-JUAN family got 29. BORKETEY family got 48. Give me Serafini, give me Priscilla. Oh, now we have the queens. Thank you for making this show look so lovely, ladies.
Thank you.
If the two of you were not here, oh, this would be a sad day. All right, let's go. In this round, we double the points. Surveyed 100 people. Top six answers on the board. Name a common drink someone would offer you at a party in Ghana.
Fanta.
Fanta.
Beer.
Beer.
Oh, yeah.
Pass or play?
We are playing. We are playing.
We are... You can talk. You don't have to listen to him.
Okay, we are playing.
Thank you. We are playing. You better have an answer when I come down here. And your answer better be on that board.
Yeah.
And you better start thinking of something, Mr. Know Everything. Augustine.
Sir?
Sir?
Name a common drink someone would offer you at a party in Ghana.
Okay, Steve, palm wine.
Yeah, palm wine! Bruce, name a common drink someone would offer you at a party in Ghana.
I'll go for water.
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 That's a good answer.
Only one strike. Joseph, you work at the bank. You never go to parties.
I go.
You don't look like a party guy. Joseph, you don't look like a party guy.
I go. Steve, I go.
Okay, well, we gonna find out now. Because they done threw a palm wine. They done named all the beers and soft drinks and malt liquor. It's really nothing else to know. You really had to be a party boy to know this answer, Joseph. And you do not strike me as a party boy.
Steve,
and that's
a
compliment.
I'm not striking you. I'll get
but
it for
it
you.
But it is a compliment.
I'm going to get for you.
Okay, you better get it. Name a common drink someone would offer you at a party in Ghana.
Steve, I think gin would do.
Gin?
That's a good answer.
We got a situation, folks. We got two strikes here. We have to be careful. Bokete family can steal. Name a common drink someone would offer you at a party in Ghana.
Steve, there's a drink we call Asana, or food drinks.
Asana?
Yeah, Asana.
Which is a food drink.
Yes.
Yeah. Asana, the fruit drink.
It's a good answer.
Name a common drink someone would offer you at a party in Ghana.
In Ghana, the one and only Sobolobo. Sobolo.
That's true.
That's right. That's
it's on the ball.
Sobolobo.
It has to be on the ball.
It has to be.
Definitely.
Okay, one more time. Say it for me.
Sobolo.
Sobolo.
Yeah.
It has got to be there.
Yeah.
There is no way you can go to a party in Ghana and don't get sobolo.
No,
party is over.
Definitely.
May I have some sobolo? We do not have it. Oh, my God.
We're going home.
And we are going to burn down your home. Sobolo.
Tell you what,
I'm getting me some damn sobolo.
Yeah, you should.
And let me tell you something. When I ask for it, you better have it. You don't have no sobolo, it's gonna be a situation.
Yes.
Number five.
Akadeshi. Almighty.
What?
Wow.
Akadeshi.
Agbet.
Genesis Apotishi.
Number two.
Alomo.
Well, may I have your attention, please? Because you have enough points on both sides where this means the same thing to both of you. You now have everything to play for because this is the last round. And the team that wins the points of this round right here will go on to play Fast Money for $5,000. LI-JUAN family, 29. Bokete family got 142. Let's get it on. Give me Augustine, give me Alfred.
This guy is dead.
All right, fellas.
Hi, Steve.
Welcome. In this round, points are tripled. Surveyed 100 people. We got the top five answers on the board. Give me a day name for a boy child.
Kojo.
Kojo.
Yeah.
Kojo. Pass the plate.
Yeah, please. We play. Let's do this.
Bruce, give me a day name for a boy child.
Steve, I'll go for Kofi.
That's a good answer. That's a good answer.
Kofi.
Let's do this.
For those of you that's watching this, let me explain it to you the best of my knowledge. In Ghana, there's a culture where it depends on what day you were born, that's the name that you get as a male child. On the day you were born, there's a certain name that you get as a female child. Joseph.
Steve.
Listen to me.
I'm listening.
You have gotten nothing right today.
I've got a lot right.
No, you have got, nothing. All of your answers are wrong. It is your chance to redeem yourself. Give me a day name for a boy child.
Steve, I think I'll go for Kwesi.
Yeah, that's a good answer.
Steve, I have it. It's there. It's here.
I have no idea. Let's hope it's there. First of all, you cannot be wrong.
Yes.
Kwesi! Serafini.
Hello.
No strikes. Give me a day name for a boy child.
Steve, I'll go for Kwame.
Great.
Yes.
That's a good name.
Why ain't nobody saying my name, man? What is all these K's? Kwame! I can't believe my name ain't up here, man. All y'all saying is names that start with a K. I'm hurt. I'm deeply hurt.
Oh, we are sorry.
Well, shut up. we are sorry. we've got a situation here. We only have one answer left on the board.
Yeah.
Your family has no strikes. You've gotten them all. If you give me this answer, your family wins the game.
Yeah.
If not, you're still alive. You have no strikes.
All right.
If you do not say my name, I hope you get it wrong.
I'll say your name.
I don't know, man. I'm just kidding. Give me a day name for a boy child.
Okay, Steve, I'll go for Kwabena.
Yeah, that's a good answer. Oh, you're going for Kwabena for the win.
Oh, that's a good answer. I
know my Ghanaian name. I know it. I've been told it. I know my African name. You know my African name? My African name is Matusi. That was given to me by the president of Botswana. I am Matusi.
Matusi.
Helper of people.
Oh, okay.
Only one strike. If it's there, only one answer. If it's there, your family wins the game. If not, you are still alive. Only one strike. Give me a day name for a boy child.
Steve, I'll go for Yao.
Yao, that was a good answer.
Go.
Take it.
Yao is a boy who was born on Thursday.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah.
The reason I know that, because that is my name. This.
Yao is there.
Boy, let me tell you something. You know how good this would be if this was up there. Oh, Father. Father win. Yao! I only dance with women. And that last one, man, they didn't give me a chance. Y'all played really well, man. Good looking family. Hey, I need two of you. Family won the game. And now it's time to play
Fast Money.
All right, Joseph, this is how Fast Money works.
Okay.
I'm going to ask you five questions in 20 seconds.
Okay.
you can't think of something, you just say pass. We have enough time, we'll get back to it.
Sure.
You and Bruce get 200 points. Tell everybody what you're gonna win.
We are gonna win $5,000.
Yes.
Yes, $5,000.
Gonna win it. You ready?
We are ready.
20 seconds on the clock.
Okay.
Clock will start after I read the first question. Come on, man. Name something a millionaire might buy.
A car.
Food that smells bad when it's rotten.
Orange.
Someone you would hire for a photo shoot.
Girlfriend.
Something women put on their face.
Makeup.
An animal that moves slowly.
A cat.
A what?
A cat.
All right, let's see how we did, buddy. Come on, let's go. Name something a millionaire might buy. You said, get a car, survey said. Yeah. A food that smells bad when it's rotten. You said, an orange, survey said. Wow. Someone you would hire for a photo shoot. You said, a little pretty girlfriend of yours. Yeah, man, yes. Survey said. Something women put on their face. You said, makeup, survey said. An animal that moves slowly. You said, the cat. Survey said. All right, let's go. All right, Bruce, let's go. All right, Bruce.
Hi, Steve.
Joseph is your good friend.
Yeah.
You met him in college?
Yeah.
Probably. Been knowing each other a long time.
Very long time.
All right, he's your friend. He needs a little bit of help. He got 72. You need 128. It's very doable. You can win this money.
We'll do this.
Oh, my man. He told me without a doubt you are going to win.
Yeah.
I'm going to ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're going to hear this song. I'll say try again. You give me another answer. It's going to be a little bit tougher this time, so I'm going to give you 25 seconds. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's remind everybody of Joseph's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name something a millionaire might buy.
A yacht.
Food that smells bad when it's rotten.
Egg.
Someone you would hire for a photo shoot.
Photographer.
Something women put on their face.
Pass.
An animal that moves slowly.
Tortoise.
Something women put on their face.
Face mask. The word is not coming.
All right, let's go, Bruce. Let's see how we did, man. We need 128 points. Let's go. Name something a millionaire might buy. You said, a yacht, survey said. Car was number one. Car was number one. Food that smells bad when it's rotten, you said. An egg, survey said. Number one answer was fish. Fish. We need 114. Come on, we need some big ones. Someone you would hire for a photo shoot, you said. The photographer, survey said. Photographer was the number one answer. 85 away. Something women put on their face, you said. Face mask, survey said. Makeup was the number one answer. An animal that moves slowly, you said. Tortoise, survey said. Chameleon. Chameleon was number one. Well, you scored 130 points. We're gonna triple that, add it to your earlier score. Walking out with a grand total, $3,520. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time. Hope you had a nice time, man. Hope you enjoyed yourself. We for sure had a good time. Had a good time. My man, Evan.